Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. I'm here with my cousin Mike, who just bought this house. And if you recognize this face from some of our older videos, it's because Mike used to work for us for a winter. Currently, he does excavating, so that's what we lost him to. But anyways, why don't you tell us a little bit about this house and why we're here?
Hey, I bought this house a couple months ago. It's an old farmhouse, and I started remodeling it. So I asked you last week what the radon levels are at, and looking for an answer.
All right, well, we'll be able to get you one. So I brought the EcoTrackers with me. Now these are not like an official radon test, but we use them all the time when we're bidding jobs for maybe that person that didn't test all the different foundation types, or if we have a crawl space, we're wondering, gosh, do we have to treat that crawl space? We'll throw them in there, and it is super helpful when we're bidding a job, because we can maybe find those areas that we would have missed otherwise. We also use them all the time when we're on the job. So the first thing John and I do when we're doing an install is scatter these around, and then we get a good baseline of what the radon levels are throughout the day. A lot of times, if it's a one-day job, when we get that fan plugged in, at the end of the day, we can see those radon levels start to drop. And a lot of times, all four of these are below one. And for the bigger projects that might take 2 or 3 days, it's great because John and I will try to get a temp, or at least part of the system in, you know, maybe it's one leg or two of something that might be 3 or 4 suction points. And we can see what those radon levels do when we come back maybe the next morning. And we might have to keep going, or we might see like, oh my gosh, we don't have to treat that upper part of the 4-level split or something like that. So it helps us speed up our decision-making process. We don't have to come back to see what the radon levels were a few weeks later. So it makes it quicker for us and also cheaper for the customer because they're not paying to mitigate areas that really don't need to be mitigated to reduce the radon. So Mike and I are gonna scatter these around. This is a 4-level split. I think it's got an addition or two. It's got a well room under the front step, but we'll scatter these around and then we'll see what our radon levels are doing. Should we get started?
Sounds good.
All right. So we'll start in the well room here. This is under the front step. And then I want to shut that so we kind of isolate that area. And then we'll do another one in here because this is kind of the lowest livable area. And then we will head up to the kitchen. So we'll throw one in here. And then we'll have our last one out in this area. So we've got each ground contact area of the house going now. So we'll check back in and see what the radon levels are. All right, so Mike, our next step is gonna be to open up the EcoTracker app now that they're all plugged in. We're gonna go to device list. This will pull up all four of the devices. And then I'm gonna set this, go into settings. And then I'm gonna take it out of continuous monitor mode and put it into hot sniff mode. And I want it to update every 10 minutes. And then I wanna clear all the old data from the previous job and I do not wanna save it. Then I'll hit done. And all we have to do now is wait. All right, Mike, we've got your data back.
How do we look?
Not so great. In the well room, we got a 6.5. In the basement, which is right below us, we got a 2.7. We got a 1.6 in the kitchen and a 2.1 in that entryway on the other side of the house. And one of the cool things about this EcoTracker app is right on the dashboard, we can see everything right in the snapshot, what they're currently reading. And then we can click on each device and see more detail about it. So we can see what the measurement time is, what the peak value is, and then what that 1-hour average is. We can also click the data tab and get into this graph where we can see, you know, the what the peaks and the valleys look like. So that's one of the great things about the EcoTracker. Again, this is not an official radon test. It's just another tool that you can add to your toolkit.
So how would you go about treating that?
So for mitigation, you've got a pretty difficult house to mitigate here. It's long and spread out. We've got four different foundation zones that would likely need to be treated if we were trying to engineer a system to create suction under the entire house. But since the highest radon levels are in that well room in the basement and those two are close to each other, I would suggest that we start with a phased approach. Maybe mitigate the well room and the basement below us here, because those could run off one system. And rather than add an additional system on that side of the house right off the bat, I'd say we start with that, let the radon monitors run, and we can see, you know, hey, does treating this part take care of that part?
Okay, that sounds good.
All right, so we're back at Mike's. Mike, the system's been up and running for a couple weeks now, and all we had to do was treat the well room where that was testing at 15, and it actually gave us pressure field extension out into the basement, which is right below us here. So that's awesome. I don't think we're gonna have to do anything else. We've had the EcoTrackers up and running for a couple weeks now, and I've got the results back on that.
Okay, what are the results?
So over in that entryway, we got a 0.8. In the kitchen, we got a 0.6. In the basement, right below us, we got a 0.6. And then in the well room, we got a 0.7. So it knocked everything down below one. So I don't think we're gonna have to add, you know, phase two or three of the system. So I think we're good. You know, EcoTracker is not a CRM or certified for that. So if you want to do a professional radon test or do an air check test kit, which is what I'd recommend here, since it's not really a real estate transaction. So that kind of just about wraps it up for this video. But if you have questions about the EcoTracker or suggestions on how you use them, leave that in the comments below. Maybe you got an idea of, you know, something we haven't thought of, and I'd love to hear it. Also, if you're thinking about purchasing the EcoTracker or the any EcoSense products, we've got an affiliate link in the description, so be sure to check that out. We've also got a promo code that gets you 5% off any of their products, so that's in the description as well. And then just as far as, you know, other ways to use the product, I was out at the Radon Symposium in Washington, D.C. A few months ago, and I was talking to Bill Broadhead about how he uses the EcoTracker, and he told me that he uses them on bids all the time. So I've started doing that, and it's great because the radon levels, or the person that was doing the radon test before you, whether it's a homeowner or a home inspector, doesn't always test the way it should be tested. Not all ground contact floors are tested. And in Mike's instance, you know, that well room is typically an area where somebody wouldn't really do a test. But putting that EcoTracker in there, and that was our highest level. You know, it was like 15 in there, and like, what was it, 3.7 or something in the basement?
Mm-hmm.
And then it was low over there, but that pointed us in the right direction of, hey, you know, let's start here. And starting there allowed us to kind of end there as well. So, great tool. Let me know how you use them. Leave it in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, consider subscribing, maybe give it a thumbs up. And until next time, I'm Jesse with American Radon, here with Mike. Thank you so much for letting us film in your house, Mike, and being on camera. I know it's not easy and it's uncomfortable, and you make it easier for me.
Yeah, so, thanks for everything you've done for me.
Yep. Well, that's it for now. Thank you.
How do I look?
Good. I'm here with my cousin, Mike. Hi, Mike. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah. No.
If you notice this, you recognize this face. Should we go that way?